Intercontinental Champion, along with Jake the Snake Roberts, along as well with Rick the Model Martel. Catchable for one fall, weighing 236 pounds, Dale Wolf. And his opponent, from Cocoa Beach, Florida, weighing 233 pounds, Rick.
Everyone, I'm Sean Mooney along with Lord Alfred Hayes. And Alfred, you have often commented that a superstar does indeed need confidence, but wouldn't you say the model Rick Martel has taken it to a new extreme?
I'm not quite sure by what you mean by that, a new extreme. He does ooze confidence.
Getting close to conceit, shall we say. Is that any clearer?
I thought that's what you were alluding to. There you saw his perfume there that he laid down. Arrogance.
You mean you can smell it? You don't need to see it.
But I like a wrestler who exudes confidence.
Rick Martel, look at this, Alfred, not wasting any time. Going right after Dale Wolf. Referee having a tough time getting control of this one. Dale Wolf already in serious trouble. This match is barely 30 seconds old.
It certainly is. This is a newfound intensity that's been exhibited here by the model. And my goodness, not only does he have expertise, he also has a lot of strength and skills.
Well, Alfred, it may come as a big surprise. The model Rick Martel likes to talk about himself. We had a chance to catch up to him earlier.
If only you could smell the way I feel. Arrogant to the last drop. And whatever I say, I can back it up because I have what it takes. Who needs confidence when you can have arrogance instead? The sweet smell of victory.
Well, Model Rick Martel, doesn't take much for him to admit that he is arrogant.
Well, I think that's all part of his ploy, quite honestly. And I think it's very successful. It's working quite well.
Dale Wolf coming back here after a couple of really nice drop kicks. Taps a hip toss. The model will have none of it.
What a nice block that was by a confident man on top of his task here. He's really at the top of the tree, Martel. He can't be long, surely, before they accept his challenge for the World Wrestling Federation title.
You think he is a top contender?
There's no doubt about that. Absolutely none whatsoever.
Wolf into the ropes once again, right into the waiting arms of the model Rick Martel. Body slam. Kind of tossed him.
Yes, it was
across
almost
the ring there.
Almost a casual thing he did there.
I think the model's having a problem with the scent of Dale Wolf. He wants to give him a sample of arrogance. It's kind of like when you walk through the department store, Alfred.
Yes.
Spraying you all the time with colognes.
I think he's enjoying himself. I think he's really having a good time at the expense of Dale Wolf, who after all is a very competent wrestler, but he's being made to look quite mediocre.
Well, we know what's coming now. Model Rick Martel executes the Boston Crab better than any superstar in the WWF, and he has it planted. And we have the submission. Let's get the official word on this encounter.
Here's your winner, Rick the Model Martel.
The model Rick Martel quite pleased with his victory here. And he plans to sweeten the victory, I guess, going after the arrogance. Alfred, we're going to get another look at some of the action that took place.
Yes, let's have a look at that. Martel was showing us tremendous form. Here's that beautiful block. Showing a lot of confidence in the ring here. What an impressive display of his skills this was. Rick Martel, a great, great wrestler, can always be relied upon to rise to the occasion. And as I said before, this man is positively a threat for the championship.
Big tear in his
eye.
What
do you have to remind you of your career?
My career?
Yeah,
my career's
mind.
Going better than ever.
I know, I opened Pandora's box. I'm impressed with Rugged Ronnie Garvin, not necessarily your career. And joining us here, Rick Martel, are you impressed with Rugged Ronnie Garvin as well? You must be. The man's fantastic.
Me impressed by Ronnie Garvin? Come on, please. You know, when I want to be impressed, all I have to do is look at myself in the mirror. But you know, watching Ronnie Garvin wrestle, you know, what I really like about him is, nothing.
What happens to Jeff Johnson?
The secret of my success, before every matchup, I pump up with this. Arrogance. It's today's man in a classic can. The fragrance that overwhelms, and pins down the competition. It's arrogance for man. Until we meet.
Saturday evening,
right,
July.
Now standing by, the model Rick Martel, talking about his opponent, the superfly, Jimmy Snuka.
You know, I always say packaging is everything. Just for instance, take a look at this beautiful designer bottle here, using this powerful fragrance inside. Yes, just like me. Class, style. But now, take a look at that Jimmy Superfly Snuka, this low class. Just take a look at the hairstyle he has, the way he talks. I have no doubts whatsoever in my mind that this guy comes from the jungle. And more than that, it's about the smell, Snuka. I don't even think arrogance can do anything for you. Now, I know these animals in the jungle. They had to be glad you left. But you know, I'm going to send you right back there.
The best dressed of the WWF set to meet the model, Rick Martel.
Korean Express of Kondo and Tanaka, managed by Mr. Fuji. Another one-on-one matchup. Tito Santana meets fashion model Rick Martel. On the Brother Love Show, it's going to be tag team action against the Orient Express. Tito Santana one-on-one against fashion model Rick Martel. Sergeant Slaughter's return to the World Wrestling Federation. He will be the special guest of Brother Love.
But right now, let's get back to this one. The model talking about the Superfly.
You know, while I was in Europe recently, all the designers in Paris offered me some big contracts to model their clothes, but I turned them all down. Because right now there's something much more important I have to take care of. You see, there's something missing in my wardrobe, my vast wardrobe. Unbelievable, but it's true. And what's missing is a belt, the World Wrestling Championship belt. And I'm going to get it because nobody can wear that belt with more elegance than me. But you see, Jimmy Snuka, you stand in my way, but not for long. Because once I get a hold of you, I'm going to send you right back in that jungle where you belong. And after that, as always, I will spray the sweet smell of victory. Because only I can do it with style.
Model Rick Martel set to meet the Superfly, the Mighty Hercules.
One-on-one. These two men at one time were tag team partners, very close friends. That's not the case any longer. One-on-one, Tito Santana squares off against the model, Rick Martel. Sergeant Slaughter will be the guest. Sato and Tanaka, managed by Mr. Fuji. Originally scheduled for this Friday night in SummerSlam, Tito Santana to meet the model, Rick Martel. But due to a conflict of interest, I can't believe it, a previous modeling engagement for Rick Martel in Paris, Rick Martel will not be at SummerSlam. That is a flimsy, in my estimation, excuse. Who's going to be replacing him? The Warlord will be taking on Tito Santana this Monday night. Watch out, it gets better all the time. The Rock and Sean.
And they don't want to forget in that calendar, Hot Rod on March. Now, they tried to get Blubber Love in there, but it took August, July, September to get him on the big. Couldn't get him all in there.
Waddle. And with that arrogance again.
Mosquito sprayer.
I think I'm beginning to like it.
Arrogance is going where no other designer fragrance has gone before.
Under your arm?
Pure liquid sex appeal. And you know, Brother Love, as I always say, great men smell great.
He always said that?
Yes!
Yes.
Of course, it does make him smell better.
Brothers and sisters.
Anything makes him smell better.
My guest is a believer.
Janitor and a drum would make him smell better.
He used to be a doubter. But now, just like each and every one of you here in this arena, and each and every one of you at home,
At least this guy is not on the calendar.
Don't have that much room.
Brother Love. Arrogance.
Oh, yes, did you cut the
smell
cheese?
Of victory. Arrogance is a fragrance that knocks the sense out of competition. Arrogance is a model fragrance.
Little crack in the voice there.
Model fragrance, huh?
Woo!
Well, thank you, Brother Model. We're all right away just a minute because you see this way. I'm going to ask if you'd stay out here on the Brother Love side. Need your services. You see, because this week I have a most unique guest. While some people say that he's sick in the head because he carries a slimy, stinky snake.
Take a look at this man, God. Talk about somebody who needs business.
Oh, there's something wrong over here.
Welcome, Brother Stinky.
Tell you something, Brother Love. There's nothing about a snake that stinks. If anything stinks in here, it's your upper lip or that wide back seat you got.
Well, if they smell, it's a stinking snake and it smells!
Those snakes stink, but it might be the people you hang around with, or it might even be your attitude, but this thing's not slimy. I can show you that.
Whoa, no! That's not necessary, Brother Snake!
Wait, Martel, look what he's doing, he's bringing a snake.
Hey, just making sure that the Brother Love Show don't stink. Now, hey, don't you worry about the model none, because he's just out here making sure, hey, you're on the show, you do as I say.
The only thing that stinks out here is attitude, my man, and you know what kind of attitude I am. I am a man that's always been a hired gun for his own stable. I am what Cain was to Abel. So you don't play no stinking games with me.
Well, I'm not here to play any games that I don't even think that you really know anything about love.
I really don't care much about love, brother.
He's going to do it again.
So don't be fooling this.
He got it right in the eye! Somebody get down there!
Martel sprayed him right in the eyes with a Paragon! He sprayed him right in the eye, I saw it!
He's hurt!
I don't know if it was intentional or not, but...
What do you mean you don't know? Of course it was!
Bossman, who scheduled up next coming out of
from the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, here's Update.
All right, hi again, everybody. Over the past several weeks, Rick the Model Martel has made his presence known, or should I say his arrogance known, by spraying the set of the Brother Love Show just prior to the interviews that Brother Love conducts. And last week, Brother Love asked the model to stay, strangely enough, on the set while he conducted his interview with Jake the Snake Roberts. Here's what happened.
I know that he's slimy, and I know he stinks because he's stinking through that bag right there, right now. He stinks, Martel, look what he's doing.
He's bringing up snake.
He's putting that...
Hey, just making sure that the Brother Love Show don't stink.
Love, brother. He's going to do it again.
Oh, don't be fooling this.
He got it right in the eye. He got it right in the eye. Somebody get down there.
Martel sprayed him right in the eyes with a Paragon. He sprayed him right in the eye. I saw it.
He's hurt.
I don't know if it was intentional.
on. Bossman, who's scheduled up next, coming out. Jake is firing him. Look at this. And he got him square in the eyes with it. Full force, right in the eyes.
In my opinion, no doubt, there appears to be great danger or damage to the eyes of Jake the Snake Roberts. Let's take you right now to Jake the Snake, who is currently at the ophthalmologist's office.
Jake, as you know, there has been vision impairment, the extent of which we won't know until next week.
Will I be able to see? That's all I'm asking you, Doc. Shoot straight with me.
All we're going to do today is remove the dressing from your eyes.
No answer.
Apply new dressing.
You listen to me.
Put some drops in, but I must warn you, the drops will be quite painful.
Quite painful. You know what it's like to walk around, man, and not be able to see anything, hear children's voices, and not be able to know where they're at? You think that's painful? Yeah, that's painful, Doc. Just tell me, man, will it happen for me? Will I get it back?
Okay.
Why is that?
Eyes
why
are
it burn?
Well.
Why does that burn? Why does that burn, man?
Drops. Huh? Tilt your head back now, Jake. Open that eye. Open your eye, Jake. Open your eye. Okay, one more now. Open your eye, Jake.
It's burning, man. It's burning.
Sponge. 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 Dressing. Next week,
we'll
determine the full extent of the vision impairment. Not until next week.
And I want to see. I want to see.
Okay, next week, Jake.
But it appears that Jake the Snake Roberts is in a great deal of pain. As the doctor said, next week, more news on the status of Jake the Snake Roberts. However, this week, the model, Rick Martel, insisted on making this statement.
Hey, I don't have to come out here and defend myself. I was on the Brother Love show doing an interview. All of a sudden, Jake the Snake Roberts comes on, shoves me, and as I fell down, arrogance sprays into his eyes. It was an accident. But, you know, being the gentleman that I am, Jake, I'd like to apologize.
Yeah, and the Barbarian, a part of the Survivor Series, as now we go to Brother Love.
You know, Brother Love.
And the Warrior, he's in the
on-deck
circle, baby.
And you have discovered victory, as I always say. If it smells good, do it.
If it smells good, do it.
Oh, Brother Model, that's
Hunk
nice.
And Rick Martel prance around out here. Knowing the condition Mark Jake the Snake Roberts is in.
Oh, but it was an accident, remember?
Well, not with the help of a physician. This man could use a little help on the couch, so to speak.
Oh, liposuction to help, too.
That
stench.
Damn you.
Terrific.
You know, Brother Love, one very important fact you need to know about arrogance, that women love it. That's right. One spray and babes from 18 to 80 all over you, just like pies on sugar. Find out for yourself. Experience the difference.
Babes?
And my guest is Wade
and the model.
Next week, brothers and sisters, right here on the Brother Love Show, my special guest will be Jake. He decided to appear.
Seeing is believing.
Well, Hot Rod, how do you see it?
Well, next week when Jake the Snake comes on the Blubber Love show, the way I see it, you, Blubber Love, will be a sight.
Oh, terrific.
Yeah, this is great, isn't it?
Oh, makes my day.
Thank you, brothers and sisters, and I can see that you made it here on the Brother Love Show this week, Brother Model.
You know, Brother Love, knowing that Jake the Snake Roberts will be your guest this week, I couldn't miss the opportunity to once again apologize for that unfortunate
accident.
You believe in this?
The fans don't.
You do know it was an accident. You?
Yeah, sure.
It was an accident. That stupid, blundering fool stepped into the smell of arrogance. It was his fault. But knowing that, I still feel sorry for Jake. I can see that he needs help. So, being the great humanitarian that I am...
Is that word?
Humanitarian, he was trying to
the
say.
The great, loving, kind, and good-hearted man that I am... I want you, Brother Love, to hand to Jake the Snake on my behalf this gift for the vision impaired.
What the hell? Oh no. This guy's a creep.
I see! What a loving human!
This guy is a creep! How low can you go?
It will be my pleasure. It indeed will be my pleasure to give this to my casket.
This is deplorable.
Jake the Snake Roberts.
Jake the Snake on his way to Brother Love. And
his pure guts walking out there.
Listen to this ovation for Jake the Snake Roberts.
Let it out your hands. Oh, come on now. Okay, let it go. Let it out up here now. Now turn around and face the TV cameras there, Brother Snake. Now that's real good. Where everybody can see.
I may not be able to see very well, but I can hear things. People, where am I at?
Well, I can say one thing. I can tell that you haven't been taking real good care of yourself there, Brother Snake, you see? Because I see you haven't shaved lately, but you see, look, I tell you what, Brother Snake, I'm going to take my glasses off. So why don't you go on ahead and take your glasses off and call it even?
You know I can't take these glasses off. The lights burn my eyes, and you better knock the crap off real quick.
Missed him.
Unfortunately.
You just wait just a minute.
You better wait. Martel, you may have taken the one thing that every man needs to see a child grow. And you may have taken the one thing that a man needs to see the beauty of life. But I promise you, if you will lead me the way, if you will show me the spot, whether it's in the back, whether it's outside, whether it's in front of these people, brother, remember this, an eye for an eye.
Jake the Snake Roberts, challenging Rick. Wait a minute, Martel's coming
you
back.
You want me? Here I am. Hey, can't you see what you look like?
On Thanksgiving night. It's going to be a team effort. You had better believe it. What a fantastic lineup. Now, earlier we saw Jake the Snake Roberts challenge the model, Rick Martel. Both men have assembled their respective teams for the Survivor Series. That match has been signed. The Vipers, captained by Jake the Snake Roberts. His team members are The Rockers, Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty, and Superfly Jimmy Snuka. Taking on the Visionaries with Captain Model Rick Martel and his team members, The Warlord, along with Power and Glory, Hercules and Paul Roma. Now, that's not all that's new for the Survivor Series. You heard earlier that World Wrestling Thanksgiving Night tradition, the Survivor Series. Here's another team, the Vipers, captained by Jake the Snake Roberts. He's joined by the Rockers, Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty, and Superfly Jimmy Snuka. Their opponents, the Visionaries. With the captain, the model, Rick Martel, joined by the Power and Glory and the Warlord. By the way, I've mentioned this in the past. I think, my opinion, Jake the Snake Roberts is getting back into the ring, getting back to the action way too soon. He had a very serious eye injury. Matter of fact, both eyes were injured at the hands of Rick the Model Martel and that Arrogance. Jake Roberts, it's his decision, will be part of the Survivor Series. By the way, at the end of the evening, it's going to be a grand finale.
Look at match. This. Headed down the ringside now.
Is that what a model wears these days?
By his manager, the Doctor of Style.
Look at this entourage.
And also accompanied by his visionary teammates,
yeah.
Captain Rick the Model Martel and Power and Glory. We have 321 pounds. The Warlord.
And there's the anchor of the team, the Warlord, along with Captain Rick Martel, leading his visionaries, joining Power and Glory. What a foursome that is.
Look at that plate in his head.
The opposing foursome, that of the Vipers, led by Jake the Snake Roberts, joined by the tag team of the Rockers, Marty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels, and those three teaming up with the Superfly Jimmy Snuka. What a matchup that's going to be at the Survivor Series this Thursday night.
You know, the counter,
look at that clothesline, goes nowhere here.
The counter to the Warlord may be Jimmy Snuka.
Are you
maybe.
Vipers, we're immune to your venom. You see why?
Immune to the venom. Ooh, wow. Jackson having his problems with the Warlord. And looking on there with a ringside seat, Power and Glory.
Isn't that Romeo?
Yeah, Paul Romeo, Roma, and Hercules. Standing by at the moment, however, Jake the Snake Roberts and his Vipers.
Oh, have your fun now. Pat on the mat and pat you on the back, because this Thursday night, at the Survivor Series, brother, you get to walk on a different side of the street. You see, we haven't really bit off of everybody, but you got to realize this. When you look at evil, brother, you get a good look, it's too late.
He's a sick puppy, Jake is, and he's on a mission. A man like that, you don't want to fool with, and what a team he's got backing him up.
An easy three count over Jackson, but it won't be so easy at the Survivor Series this Thursday. That is for certain. The party's just going to begin this Thursday night, I can tell you that. And by the way, for those of you who don't already have your tickets for the Hartford Civic Center Survivor Series this Thursday, it's a little bit too late. But you can buy a ticket at home on pay-per-view. Let's go back and take a look at the replay, Hot Rod.
Check him out. Took a look at this suplex. Didn't even bow down. Lifted him over his head standing. Now check this out. Again, driving the sternum. And look at the mug on this guy. I am the Walrus. Yeah.
He can also be victorious along with the rest of his visionaries. Comment from the Visionaries.
Jake the Snake and the Vipers, after this Thursday night, you're going to look more like a bunch of limp worms.
And you know, being the Visionaries come this Thursday night, it's very clear to us that there's going to be a lot more crippling going on.
Martel would know about limp worms, man. Look at the damage he caused. Jake still, the seasoned veteran that he is.
He's got another great matchup, the Vipers, led by Captain Jake the Snake Roberts, joined by the Rockers and Superfly Jimmy Snuka, are going to be facing the Visionaries, captained by the model Rick Martel, joined by Power and Glory and the Warlord. Another great one slated for this Thursday night of the Survivor.
The model, Rick Martel, will join us, along with Dustin Rhodes. Mr. Perfect, Rick Martel, and his hot rod just mentioned, will show you highlights of the match between...
Take you back to the footage and show you highlights of the matchup between the Ultimate Warrior and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. That was a barn burner.
That is a model?
Well,
look at the schnoz on that guy.
Oh, but that's so cute, isn't it, huh?
That's supposed to be impressed, huh? Oh, this guy is too much. And by the way, standing by, so we are told, Jake the Snake Roberts in the dressing room area.
It's a good thing he's in the dressing room.
Yeah. Well, the model there with that can of arrogance, and we know...
He's got the nerve to say Pez things.
Huh. Yeah. Can you smell that stuff from up here?
That is Pez.
I wouldn't say that it's unpleasant, but...
Let me help you out. Okay. It stinks. It's unpleasant.
Well, I know one thing.
Cross your heart, Paul.
If it's sprayed in your eyes, you know the result of that. Wait a minute. Standing by, Jake the Snake Roberts. Jake, what sort of special plans do you have for Rick the Model Martel?
Special? Nothing special, Rick. I'm sorry. Nothing really planned for you except to take from you what you took from me. Just for a while. You know what one day is like, God? Without your sight. You know, Survivor Series, you sacrificed everyone on your team to keep your skinny little away from me. But right now, you got to do it face to face, one on one.
Sounds to me like Martel better keep hold of them sunglasses he brought down to the ring, because he's going to need them. Jake the Snake is an obsessed man that doesn't know when to stop.
Yeah. And this man, the model Rick Martel, is obsessed in his own way, because once he gains an advantage over you, just like he has right now over Pez Watley, he's going to keep it. He loves to dish it out. He's one of the most aggressive individuals in the WWF today.
Absolutely. And another thing that Jake said that didn't make sense, he says, you're skinny little. There ain't nothing about Martel that's skinny or little. He's a fine conditioned athlete, but Jake is way out there looking for the throat. You got to think, Jake, but he's fine.
Or is vision impaired, isn't it?
Vision impaired.
We found out at the Survivor Series that that one eye... It's likely to get him into trouble in single competition.
So much guts, though. He won't quit. Vision impaired. Whatever you want to call it, the guy don't see straight. And I'm not so sure he's thinking straight getting in the ring with Martel this soon.
Good point, but he certainly wants him. You could not keep Jake the Snake out of there. No way. As now the model, Rick Martel, with Pez Watley, whips him off. Misses with the elbow. Pez with the left hand. It had an effect, but not a tremendous effect on Martel. But it may be enough to put him off balance. Yes. First now, moving in. Well-seasoned performer, Pez Watley, in his own right. And telegraphed that one, and now the model back in control.
Telegraph.
The model wasting no time, trying to get Pez over. Boston Crab, the model style, that should do it, indeed it does. Let him go. This man raises my ire, Rick Martel. I mean, I could almost hate him. I know Jake the Snake does. But what he did at first, Martel spraying the arrogance in the eyes, I thought it was an accident. He even said it was an accident. And then from there,
he became the greatest liar in the WWF. Give me a break, Martel. Get a life, man.
Well, maybe the same thing will happen to you, Martel. It happened to Jake the Snake, maybe even worse. And if it happens, you deserve it.
Jake the Snake Roberts. Right now, the brother of love is standing by with a model.
Well, Jake the Snake, last time you and I were on the Brother Love Show, I had a gift for you, a white cane. Well, this time I just might have another gift. We'll keep it as a surprise.
What a loving human being you are indeed, Brother Model. And right here in the Boston Gardens, we're going to show all of Boston. We're going to show you, Brother Snake. We're going to show you, Brother Puppy Dog, just how much we love you right here in Boston. Yes.
Well, I'm sure Brother Love and Rick Martel
and the Canadian Strongman. But right now, it's the model talking about the snake.
Now, Jake the Snake, now you're all excited and upset at the same time. Because now, finally, you see that you have me in the ring, one-on-one. No brother love show, no seen-eyed dog and all that crap, like you say. But I strongly believe that not only you're suffering a vision impairment, but serious brain damage. Because one-on-one with me in that ring, with your vision impairment, you can't see me too well. Well, am I going to have some fun with you? Because even with your eyesight 20/20, your ability don't even match up with mine. So now imagine. You know, I gave you a white cane once, but maybe I'm going to have another gift for you. A wheelchair this time.
Model set to meet the Snake. Awesome.
If Rick Martel comes his way in the Royal Rumble. There he is, Mr. Martel. Rick, are you concerned about Jake the Snake's ever-improving vision?
I'm not the least bit concerned about Jake the Snake's improving vision. I can guarantee you that 1991 and after the Royal Rumble, once again, Jake the Snake will be in total darkness.
maybe not.
I don't know. I think Martel ought to hang on to them sunglasses. He may need them after Jake's
dog man. The Undertaker with manager Brother Love. Tugboat. Rick the Model Martel. The Earth.
Butch from the Bushwhackers. Superfly Jimmy Snuka. Fashion model Rick Martel. Tugboat. With Brother Love, The Undertaker.
I will take the Royal Rumble.
Even I have to admit the Royal Rumble will be a very tough match. You know, you have a fresh man come into the ring every 2 minutes, and one of them will be Jake the Snake, looking for revenge. Don't worry about finding me in that ring, Jake, because I will find you.
Superstars, Kevin Adonis will be the model, Rick Martel. The British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, will have a special Royal Rumble. The British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, as well as the model, Rick Martel.
But you've got butterflies, don't you?
Oh, I'm hitting on about 16 cylinders. I got the 59 Cadillac tuned up, and it's ready to go.
It is.
I'm going to be leading the convoy.
Well, one of your opponents, one of the 29 opponents you will face, making 30 in the event, is this man, the model Rick Martel.
And I'd like to say that I really believe that he is a model. He looks like a model. And I know you don't like it, Piper, but he looks like a model.
Well, what do you figure? I mean, Pierre Cardani, ain't? What do you figure he models?
The arrogance.
Yeah, he models that all right.
He models that.
And we've seen him in some fashion magazines from time to time. But however, inside the can of arrogance is something that you honky-tonk may be very leery of, because if it's sprayed in your eyes like it was Jake the Snake's, you're going to wind up just like Jake wound up.
Oh, how was that? Feeling around in the dark saying, please, please, somebody lead me around?
Yeah, you think that's funny? Well, Jake the Snake could also be, and is in fact, another opponent of yours in the Royal Rumble. He may be looking for the model Rick Martel, but he may find you first.
While he's busy looking for the model Rick Martel, a honky-tonk man to sneak up behind him.
Oh, really? And who's going to be sneaking up behind the honky-tonk? We spoke to the model earlier on about the Royal Rumble. Here's what he had to say.
A week from now, the Royal Rumble, everybody will have to pick a number to find out the order they enter the ring, except one, Jake. Yes, with your eyesight, you're going to have someone help you pick that number. But don't worry once you get in that ring, because I will guide you along right over the top.
Yeah, I bet.
Any kind of luck, maybe Martel will pick number one, and he can stay in there for 60 minutes.
I like how you said somebody would have to pick the number for Jake, because Jake couldn't see how to do it.
You liked that one, did you, Honker?
What an unusual sense of humor, Honky.
Hit your funny bone, did it, Honker?
I just like the fact that this man did absolutely nothing wrong. He stumbled and fell over Damien, and that's how Jake got sprayed. I know the history behind it.
Well, yeah. Just a second. I just heard the model say, Jake, this is for you, as he gouges his fingers in the guy's eyes.
Yeah, that's the kind of man the model is.
Yeah, that does remind me of the way Jake was swinging out there.
The model, Rick Martel, in complete control. Just how much control he's going to have in the Royal Rumble in a week, we're going to find out. It's every man for himself.
Vicious.
And again, we have questioned the wisdom of Jake the Snake as to whether or not he should even enter the Royal Rumble. Hot Rod?
Well, nothing. The Royal Rumble's, what, a week away? Nothing's going to change for the better in a week. And, Jake, there's the Boston Crab Martel's got on. Jake, I think you better watch what you're doing. I don't think you're ready for Martel.
And I don't think Hardy Talk is ready for him either.
I am ready for the Royal Rumble. Every 2 minutes, somebody else comes to the ring, and I'll be ready.
Are you ready for Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog? Are you ready for Hulk Hogan? Are you ready for the Macho King? Are you ready for Hacksaw Jim Duggan? Are you ready for Hawk, Animal, Earthquake, Hercules? I don't think so. And are you ready for the latest edition of the magazine? Available this Tuesday. By the way, you may want to read all about some of the decisions.
There's going to be a rumble, the Royal Rumble, next Saturday night, only on pay-per-view. 30 of the toughest World Wrestling Federation superstars battle it out in a match where it's every man for himself. There are no allies, only enemies. It's friend versus friend, foe versus foe, until only one man is left standing. Plus, the World Wrestling Federation champion, the Ultimate Warrior, defends his title against Sergeant Slaughter. There's going to be a rumble, the Royal Rumble, next Saturday night, only on pay-per-view.
All right,
this
gentlemen, we're
back. The Undertaker with Brother Love. Hacksaw Jim Duggan. The Model Rick Martel. Jake the Snake Roberts. Macho King Randy Savage.
There's going to be a rumble, the Royal Rumble. Tonight, only on pay-per-view. 30 of the toughest World Wrestling Federation superstars battle it out in a match where it's every man for himself. There are no allies, only enemies. It's friend versus friend, foe versus foe, until only one man is left standing. Plus, the World Wrestling Federation champion, the Ultimate Warrior, defends his title against Sergeant Slaughter. There's going to be a rumble, the Royal Rumble, tonight, only on pay-per-view.
Continental champion, Mr. Perfect, and this man, fashion model, Rick Martel.
This Saturday night, the Royal Rumble, even I have to admit it. It's not gonna be easy. One freshman coming to the ring every 2 minutes. You know, 30 total. And one of them will be Jake the Snake, who wants revenge. Well, I know with your eyesight, Jake, don't worry about having difficulty finding me, because I will find you. And once the dust clear, I will be declared the winner. But of course...
There's more, including the Warlord.
Next week, joining us on the Superstars of Wrestling will be Rick the Model Martel, along with the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, plus the Canadian law enforcement official, the Mountie. Then we'll see tag team action of the Legion
All
of
right,
the...
we're back with more action, and you know, speculation abounds, Hot Rod, as to what Jack Tunney's going to announce this Friday night as it relates to WrestleMania. What's the main event going to be? I mean, obviously, we're going to have a title defense by whomever is going to be the champion. Will Sergeant Slaughter be victorious this Friday night against Hacksaw Jim Duggan? Or will there be a rematch with Duggan and Sarge at WrestleMania? Then again, the Macho King Randy Savage was granted, as far as Sergeant Slaughter was concerned, the right to face him as number one contender. Will it be Sarge and Savage at WrestleMania should Sergeant Slaughter be victorious this Friday night?
Wait, don't you think the Ultimate Warrior is the number one contender also? I believe he definitely is a strong horse in there.
All right, I got something else for you then.
What's that?
If you're going that way, what about Hulk Hogan? Winner of the Royal Rumble. And on top of that, Hogan never got an opportunity to face the Warrior for a rematch after WrestleMania 6, so I think you've got to throw Hogan's hat in there as well.
Storms of ruin!
And then again, maybe there's somebody else with the initials RP that's going to be in there.
You never know what I might do. Now let's check out the model person.
Yeah. Well.
Nice tan.
Very nice tan. Nice skin, too.
Nice skin.
Yeah.
The other guy's got a tremendous headlock on him.
Certainly does. Reaching for the leg, Martel, a consummate wrestler, and going to work on the knee. The model, Rick Martel, you may not like him, but certainly you have to appreciate his wrestling technique. The model dragging his opponent to the... Oh, come on. Oh, not on the ring post. This is a vicious man. Oh, come on. We spoke to the model earlier.
Jake the Snake, now that the Royal Rumble is over, I've added a new ingredient to arrogance. That makes it more arrogant than ever. And Jake, let me tell you, it is not hypoallergenic.
This guy's got an odd sense of humor here.
Yeah, not hypoallergenic. No kidding.
He's got the Steven Seagal hairdo.
Please. The model Rick Martel in control.
Liking him less all the time.
Certainly we're looking forward again to this Friday night, not just because of Jack Tunney's announcement of the main event of WrestleMania, but also, well, again, Duggan versus Sergeant Slaughter. This is all over. And after Friday night, maybe Sergeant Slaughter's reign as champion will be over. He goes, who better to represent the wounded?
Model here. Notice knows exactly what he's doing. Picks him up, holds him until he's got him in position, drops him on that leg perfectly, goes in for now becoming the model's patented move, Boston Crab, and you've got to take note of that.
Yes, indeed you do. He's pleased with himself.
Talking about
maybe
the teeth.
He's the only one. Look at those teeth.
Like a knock him out.
Since he has been involved in singles competition, the model Rick Martel has posed a threat to every superstar he has faced in the ring, especially Jake the Snake Roberts. But as the model found out, the Snake only responds to threats with his own explosive violence. And when it comes to violent acts of nature, no superstar is more destructive than the earthquake. He's joined by the Mouth of the South.
Defend against the Big Boss Man. Two of the biggest and strongest collide. The British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, to meet the Warlord. In a blindfold match, what a bizarre match this will be. Jake the Snake Roberts squares off against this man, the model Rick Martel.
Yes, my blood is running hot. Yes, I was tricked into this blindfold match at WrestleMania against Jake the Snake. Yes, and the crime of it all is that I had to cover this beautiful face. But you know what, Jake? You're gonna regret the day that you heard of Rick the Model Martel.
March 24th, Rick Martel, WrestleMania 7. You think about it, man. I live...
In another great matchup, Jake the Snake Roberts. He meets the model Rick Martel in a blindfold match.
So, Jake the Snake, you're walking around with that big smile on your face these days. You're happy. You're laughing because first you tricked me into this blindfold match at WrestleMania 7. Yes, the fine prince. And now you're counting on your fans to help you in that ring, to help you, to direct you. Yeah, watch out, Jake. On your left, on your right. Yeah, you think you're real smart, huh? Well, I figured out a way to find you in that ring at WrestleMania 7, even though I have this on, even though I can't see you. And you know how? By your smell. That's right, Jake, because you stink. As a matter of fact, you would need a little arrogance.
Amon's hood? No. Might as well
joking,
be.
Randy Savage. Let's talk about that fantastic card that is going to be part of WrestleMania 7. Jake the Snake Roberts to meet the model Rick Martel in a blindfold match. Both men will have hoods over their heads. The Intercontinental title will be on the line as champion Mr. Perfect defends against the Big
Superstar
Boss Man.
Who is definitely running a high temperature is the model Rick Martel. The fashion plate is standing by with comments.
You know, I'm having so much fun, enjoying all the success that I deserve, of course. Take a look at this beautiful body. And you know, by now all you people know that when I said that the model is the man of the 90s, you know that I meant it. And of course, when I say that arrogance knocks the sense out of competition, you know that is right also. Now, I am waiting. Get in line, opponents, so I can knock you all down. Arrogance, arrogant, of course, I have all the reasons to be.
Well, so far in 1991, the model has certainly given his opponent several reasons to fear him. Standing by right there.
And the Undertaker, and then from there, one-on-one. It's Rowdy Roddy Piper squaring off against the model, Rick Martel. Well, yes, indeed, the entire world, including the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, will be watching your match, Roddy Piper.
Yes.
Next week with the model, the question is whether or not the knee is back at 100% capacity.
100%. When I get through with you next week, Rick the Model Martel, the only place you'll be modeling is a Fred G. Sanford Salvage and Son Company.
What about it, Macho Man?
Model's gonna beat you because the knee's not 100%, and what the model doesn't take, the $1 million man will. Right to the bank.
Never. Join us next week, one-on-one.
Yeah! Happy Mother's Day.
Introduction to the Piper Martel encounter. We'll see in action the Undertaker, the Big Boss Man, Sergeant Slaughter. Superstars!
Next week, right here on Superstars, scheduled return to action will be the model, Rick Martel.
And then the Big Boss Man will be here.
In addition to which, we will announce all the remaining superstars participating in the Royal Rumble.
In the Royal Rumble, as well as in the Squared Circle this week, the Big Boss Man, he'll be joined by the model, Rick Martel.
Talking about admitting that Ric Flair is the real world champion.
The Barbarian, back from Europe, the model, Rick Martel. And from the Middle East, this man, Colonel Mustafa.
10 and over 300 pound marks, certainly supposed to, it's going to be something to be looked at. But then again, he's just coming off the injured reserve, and I don't think he's got what it takes to be the champ right now.
I don't know about that. The Big Boss Man joining the Frey in the Royal Rumble. Sergeant Slaughter, the tag team of the Rockers. Superfly Jimmy Snuka, on and on and on. And of course, the Intercontinental title will be up for grabs. What with the Mountie squaring off against the Hitman, whom you know a great deal about.
Well, if anybody knows the Hitman, it's me, McMahon. And I'm looking for the Mountie to give Bret the Hitman Hart the shock of his life.
Real funny. Speaking of shock, take a look at the shocking pink outfit we just saw a moment ago there on the model, Rick Martel. The model making his return to action here in the... He's been modeling over in Europe and over in Asia, and has decided to return to action.
I was talking to the model, and he told me that he's got such a busy schedule modeling throughout the world that it's hard for him even to come back. But now with the Royal Rumble in the air and everything, he's making the return, and he looks better than ever.
How about that? Thus far, we've seen some scientific wrestling here on the part of the model. Wants to shake hands. How about that? We may be seeing a new model. I guess we are. Wait a minute. What is this?
I can't believe
what
that.
What happened to the arrogance of the model? Rick Martel winding up his opponent, Dale Wolf. To the ropes now. Off the rope, over his man, coming right back. The model over the hip. No, nice reversal. Nice kick out by Wolf. Both men right back up.
Dale Wolf showing some good action here.
Can't get over those pink tights by the model. And again, he wants another handshake.
I'm not going for it, McMahon.
Well, let's see if Dale Wolf goes for it. No doubt inside the canister there, the fragrance of arrogance. And yes, another handshake. What is going on? Perhaps a new leaf has been turned, so to speak, with the model, Rick Martel. Wolf down against the rope. Model sends him in for the ride. Nice leapfrog coming from the backside now. Both men back on their feet. Another leapfrog back off the ropes. Rick Martel on the money with the elbow.
This guy's great, Martel.
We had an occasion to chat with the model a little bit earlier on concerning his entrance into the Royal Rumble.
The winner of the Royal Rumble will be the new World Wrestling Federation champion. And ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at him. That's right. Moi, a model champion.
A model champion. Well, you know, the thing about this Royal Rumble, anyone can win. I mean, Lady Luck has to be on your shoulders regardless of the amount of ability you have. And just anyone can win it. I mean, sure, you've got the Hulkster in there and the Undertaker and, yes, I know, Ric Flair.
Right.
And the Macho Man Randy Savage and Sid Justice and on, Roddy Piper and on and on. Whoa, look at this. Now we're seeing, the old model, Rick Martel.
Turn the volume up a little bit, Martel. Show them how you are.
Oh, no.
Look at that.
Oh, no. Well, we're not seeing any scientific display of skills here. like we did earlier on.
He might have broke the guy's back throwing him into the pole like that.
Break your heart if he did, huh?
Really?
The model with Dale Wolf down on the knee, down to the canvas. And what's he going to do? Trying to get him over. The model, Rick Martel with Dale Wolf.
It's over.
And yes, indeed it is. So just when you thought you're going to see a change of heart on the part of the model, Rick Martel, he shows us his true colors, which just happened to be shocking pink. But he could be, folks, the next champion.
Just like me.
That's for sure. Arrogant through and through. Let's go back and take another look.
Now here you see him shaking hands, and then it comes the mighty clothesline. Change of directions. There you go. That is the model, Rick Martel. And there you see the cover of the WWF Bodybuilding Lifestyles magazine. You want to model yourself?
Let's go back and take a look at some of the footage from last year's event.
And look at this, the model with a slam on Davey Boy. Where's he going? Man, what a risk at this point. What a risk. Not the place to be. Oh. And there goes the model.
He's out of there. Singing soprano.
Wow, as you can see, anything can happen at a Royal Rumble. This year's participants... The British Bulldog, IRS, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and the self-proclaimed Real World's Champion. Let's hear from Ric Flair.
Oh, Lord, how it comes.
Also, Greg the Hammer Valentine, the model Rick Martel, Sid Justice, and the rockers Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty. The Warlord, thus Greg the Hammer Valentine, the model Rick Martel, Rocker Shawn Michaels, Rocker Marty Jannetty,
the WWF Champion.
Arrogance, new and improved, just like the mouth. And I'm gonna prove it to you and the rest of the world when I win the Royal Rumble and the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
All right, folks, 30 of the greatest superstars in the World Wrestling Federation. All
we're back with more WWF action and back with Mr. Perfect. We certainly saw you earlier on in the update from Royal Rumble. You and the undisputed WWF champion Ric Flair giving the credit where it's due. But aren't you wondering just whom Jack Tunney is going to select as the ranked number one contender who will face you at WrestleMania?
Well, certainly we're concerned with that, McMahon, but right now all we're concerned with is that he's the World Wrestling Federation champion. Like I said, I don't mean to be a know-it-all or a I-told-you-so, McMahon, but you live with that.
Well, there we see a man who no doubt was at the celebration party after the Royal Rumble, the model Rick Martel. A personal invitation from you, we understand, Mr. Perfect.
Yeah, and at that party, there was a lot of big shots there, and he got a lot of offers to do some modeling from that.
I imagine he got a lot of offers. What is that odor?
It's Arrogance, McMahon. Why don't you try some sometime?
Did they actually bottle that stuff? I didn't think you could actually bottle Arrogance.
It's a special recipe.
No doubt. The model, Rick Martel. Cummerbund is off, little bow tie is released, and... Now we take a look at the model. Oh, there's the container of the Arrogance. Be interesting to find out what the Hulkster has to say on his hotline this week concerning the possibility of being named the number one contender to face Ric Flair.
I'd like to hear that myself, McMahon.
And right now, trying to dominate this matchup from the get-go. Yes, nice drop kick there by the model, Rick Martel. Mike J having his problems earlier on.
The model, a very talented athlete. I respect his wrestling ability to the utmost.
You do, huh?
Sir.
What about the color of those tights? Give me a break. What kind of fashion statement is that?
Well, he has so many different outfits he can wear. I think pink today might have been the right color for the guy to wear.
Have you ever worn pink before, Mr. Perfect?
No, have you?
I asked you first. I mean, Mr. Perfect in pink has a nice ring to it.
No, I answered you. I said no.
Mr. Martel making a fashion statement, and more than that, wanting to make a wrestling statement here as well. Hoping to take on the top contenders. And by the way, later on, we will be hearing from the top five contenders that Jack Tunney has designated to face Ric Flair. We'll hear from all of them as to why they feel they should be chosen the number one contender.
Yeah, we'll hear them all, McMahon. I'm
no
sure
doubt,
that.
Pardon me, but no doubt one of them will unquestionably be the Huckster.
How do you know that?
Please. Many think he should have won the Royal Rumble as it was.
Well, like many others, McMahon, you think a lot of things, but some people think, some people go out and do it. Ric Flair did it. He's the World Wrestling Federation champ.
You know, I mean, you give some insight as to you and Mr. Flair as to really what kind of champion you're going to be. I mean, you know, this man has bottled arrogance, but he must get it from you guys and somehow liquefy it and bottle it, because you and Ric Flair are the two most arrogant WWF title holders or associated I've ever seen in my life.
Well, good observation, McMahon. You're absolutely right. It's because we're the two greatest wrestlers the World Wrestling Federation has ever seen, and we know it.
Said so humbly. Mr. Martel now moving Mike Jay into position, and Jay wastes no time whatsoever in surrendering.
It's hard on the lower back, McMahon.
So there is the model, Rick Martel. Once again victorious, and no doubt looking for action in the WWF. Well, I don't think that he's all that well liked.
Well, they're all jealous because he looks so good in anything he wears.
New and improved. New and improved arrogance, huh? And there he is. No, Mr. Martel.
Oh, he was looking at you when he did that, McMahon.
Well, here's a young man looking at you, looking at all of us. Major Gun. You know, I couldn't believe it when Sid Justice, at the conclusion of Saturday night's main event about a week ago, stated that Hulkster couldn't beat Flair on his best day, and furthermore couldn't beat him, Sid Justice, on his worst day.
Well, we're going to find out just what kind of day Hulk Hogan's going to have at WrestleMania. I can tell you that when those two lock up together.
Well, McMahon, whether he has a good day or a bad day, I'll guarantee you one thing. Neither one of them can beat Ric Flair.
I think the man who can beat Ric Flair and will beat Ric Flair is the Macho Man Randy Savage. And what's this stuff about?
You guys know something about the Macho Man that he doesn't know.
Well, we know something about the Macho Man that might influence his wrestling abilities at WrestleMania. That's all I'm going to say about it right now, McMahon.
All roads will lead to the Worcester Centrum 1 week from this Monday night, February 24th, for live WWF action. The Undertaker will be there leading the British Bulldog. You'll also see the Big Boss Man, the Nasty Boys, and the main event, the one-on-one encounter in the steel cage as WWF Champion Ric Flair meets Intercontinental Champion Rowdy Roddy Piper. The main event 1 week from this Monday night at the Centrum in Worcester.
Yeah, he's proud of himself, isn't he? The model, Rick Martel. Another man who's proud of himself is the WWF champion, Ric Flair, on the cover of the current edition of the WWF magazine. And, of course, on the inside, yes, the personality profile of you-know-who.
Just not another pretty face. Talking of faces, McMahon.
Yeah?
I don't see Brutus the Barber Beefcake around. He shows his face in any arena around the World Wrestling Federation, and Sid Justice just might rearrange it for him.
He's not going to show his face. I mean, again, it was like, what Sid Justice did to Brutus the Barber Beefcake should not be done to another man. He emasculated him.
Well, McMahon, Beefcake tried to stick his nose in where it doesn't belong. Whatever you want to say about it, one thing's for sure. If Sid Justice gets a hold of Beefcake, he will rearrange that face.
I'll tell you something else that's for sure. Next week, we're going to show you the matchup in its entirety between the Macho Man Randy Savage and Jake the Snake Roberts. We'll show you what you saw last weekend on Saturday night's main event. It will also show you what you did not see.
Well, that's what I'm looking forward to, McMahon, what you didn't see. I know what's going on, McMahon. I can't wait to see this.
Jake the Snake Roberts was laying in wait to ambush Savage and Elizabeth. We'll show you that next week. What a dastardly thing to do.
Nice backbreaker.
Not bad, not bad. But then again, of course, not perfect.
Right, McMahon.
The model trying to get Daniels over and... That's Boston Crab, that should do it. The model applying the pressure. It's over.
The Model, Rick Martel, victorious. And again, you wonder who will be victorious. What news by WWF President Jack Tunney? The two main events headed to WrestleMania. Thumbs down for the Model, maybe even for the WWF champion, Ric Flair.
Folks, if you're planning to catch all the action live at the Boston Garden...
Standing by now, the Model, Rick Martel, with pre-recorded comments.
You know, Tatanka, a few weeks ago, by attacking me as I was leaving the ring, minding my own business, you just showed everybody that you have no class. And I will treat you as such this Sunday afternoon at WrestleMania.
I gotta agree with him with one thing. I think that Tatanka has no class, but the class he does have is all
Taker, accompanied by Paul Bear. Tatanka goes against the Model Rick Martel, the British Bulldog, to beat the Berserker managed by Mr. Fuji.
We're just 2 weeks away from the World Bodybuilding Federation Championship, just 2 weeks away when Bobby Heenan presents Lex Luger, who will be the guest poser. You judge for yourself whether or not when you watch on pay-per-view all over the country, whether or not Lex Luger belongs on the same stage as the other World Bodybuilding Federation superstar.
Hey, McMahon, they don't call him the total package just because he's an ordinary guy. You wait till you see this guy, then you'll know why he's the total package.
I mean, you're going to see on pay-per-view the most extraordinary physiques in the world, all battling it out, all competing to be the WBF champion. The championship itself setting the standard for drug-free competition. Will it be Gary Stridham repeating as champion, or will it in fact be a newcomer? Who knows? But it won't be Lex Luger.
Well, he'll be the guest poser, McMahon.
Yeah, I'm sure, and he's going to put everybody to shame, right?
Yeah, you've been reading my mail?
Not hardly. The Model, Rick Martel, with a great physique in his own right. We had an occasion to speak with him earlier on. Here's what he had to say.
Buffalo breath, Tatanka. You just keep crying and whining because if you want to dance with this Ross, the war path that you travel now will soon become a trail of tears.
You gotta love that, McMahon. Buffalo breath. What a smart thing to say.
Yeah, look at that maneuver. Oh, that's even a better one by Jimmy Powers. And another one. Martel having his problems with Jim Powers, and no doubt likely to have even bigger ones with Tatanka. Tatanka thus far undefeated in the WWF. I believe Martel is going to pay a price, a dear price.
No, he's not. He's going to clean up that Indian's act. He's going to get rid of that stench that follows him around. He's going to spray him with some arrogance and show him what arrogance is all about.
I think he already knows what arrogance is all about. Remember? What up in the eyes? One, two, and three. No, almost. I couldn't believe Martel. You claimed that was some sort of accident, Martel spraying Tatanka in the eyes?
Yeah, I told you what happened. Somebody opened the back door in the arena, and the big breeze came up, and it blew right into his eyes.
Yeah, right. A fashion motto. Matter of fact, Martel claims the latest in fashion from Paris are eagle feathers. That's some sort of a joke by Martel.
Let's see Buffalo Breath get out of that one.
Yeah, I'd like to see those feathers worn by Martel crammed down his throat.
Yep, get the stench off him. Good job.
Yeah, it's stench, all right. That's the smell of arrogance. Oh, come on, look at this.
What a touch of class this guy has. Look at that.
Yeah, oh, the hat tilted just so. Uh-huh.
That's cool.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, sure. Standing by, Sean Mooney.
Welcome back. I have just received a bulletin concerning this.
The Model, Rick Martel, made these comments earlier on.
Tatanka, it was so easy to outsmart you. When we meet and I beat you, be just like putting another feather in my cap. Besides, they look so good on you.
McMahon, there was no authority in his voice. The man's scared. Boss man knows what he went through. All those bruises on his body, they call him the big bruise man now, you know.
They do, huh? I wonder what they're going to be calling nails after the big boss man gets into the ring with him.
Calling him a champion.
I don't know about that. He's a tough one, this guy Nails is, that's for sure. Thumbs down at the moment for the model, Rick Martel.
People just don't know class when they see it.
The model is a moron?
He wears this big pendant there. Is he wearing a big butt to remind him that he's a model?
Yeah, don't forget about the feathers, McMahon.
Yeah, I know. The latest in fashion, courtesy of Tatanka, huh?
What a trendsetter.
A trendsetter?
Oh, yeah.
Are you following the trends of the model Rick Martel?
To some extent.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, you use the same cologne?
None of your business, McMahon.
Huh?
Don't try jumping on the wagon.
I see. We had occasion to speak with the model, Rick Martel, a little bit earlier on, and here's what the model had to say.
Tatanka, I thought it was a great Indian tradition to be brave. I am disappointed because it was so easy to embarrass you. Please, don't let me do it again. Because this time, you might lose more than just a few feathers.
The model, Rick Martel, sporting quite a physique in his own right. Speaking of physiques, you don't want to miss Body Stars next week, ladies and gentlemen, at a new time. Body Stars will be seen Saturday mornings at 10 a.m. So start your morning off right every Saturday with Body Stars at 10 o'clock.
Then next week also, McMahon, the return of the total package, Lex Luger.
Even more importantly on Body Stars, you'll see the championship performance of the WBF champion, the greatest bodybuilder in the world today, the WBF champion, Gary Stridham. All that and more on Body Stars next Saturday at 10 o'clock. And right now, the model is pretty much taking care of business in there against Jason Knight.
Like always.
No, not like always.
Martel always takes care of business, McMahon. The guy's a class act all the way.
Really?
Yep.
Driving those pink knee pads to the chest area of Jason Knight.
Makes it look easy, doesn't he?
I don't know about that. Nice reversal there. Martel to the buckle, and yes! Here we go, from the top monkey. No. Oh.
Trying to be a show-off. That's what you get.
Martel, pretty much with things under control at the moment. Oh, my. Driving a knee.
Right into the kidney area.
That's smart. And trying to get him over now for the Boston Crash. The model, Rick Martel, applying the pressure, and it's all over. And the canister, of course, Arrogance. That must be the same cologne you wear.
Well, it's the smell of success, McMahon.
The smell of Arrogance. And again.
See that guy? He thinks those feathers stink, too.
Model Rick Martel being held back by the official. He's used that spray on more than one occasion to impair the vision of his opponents as we go back for the replay.
Here you see a side suplex, McMahon, followed up with only the way Rick Martel can do it, the Boston Crab.
The model Rick Martel with a whiff of Arrogance.
The darkness rules.
Also just fine to meet at Wembley Stadium, Shawn Michaels, along with Sensational Sheriff, will clash head-on with the model Rick Martel. Let's get comments from these two.
Now, Shawn Michaels, everybody knows that you're jealous of me because I'm always surrounded with the world's most beautiful women. And that you're stuck with that truck stop beauty queen, Sherry. But you know, when you interfere in my match against Bret the Hitman Hart for the Intercontinental Championship, and I had him beat, you cost me the title. You went too far. So, boy toy, you've beat a bad boy. I'm gonna have to teach you some manners. And believe me, at SummerSlam, I will do so.
Apparently we cannot get comments from Shawn Michaels. But Shawn Michaels has left the building. By the way, the excitement is building. Next week, we're gonna
We're back with more WWF Superstars.
Scheduled for one fall.
Oh, my goodness.
Weighing 243 pounds,
the model, Rick Martel.
Yes, he is a model.
Martel still sporting the feathers.
From New York City.
See, the girl wants thumbs up. The girl wants thumbs up.
Bill Pierce to lock up with the model. And the model, Rick Martel, has problems not only with Tatanka these days, but he's also going to have problems, if you can imagine this, with Shawn Michaels at SummerSlam. I mean, there's a... one's going to be interested in, only to see... well, badly, one beats up the other one.
I agree with you there.
I mean, it is indeed the SummerSlam you thought you'd never see before.
Yeah, I never thought I wouldn't see Ric Flair going for the World Wrestling Championship either.
Well, then again, you never thought you'd see the Ultimate teaming up with the Macho Man Randy Savage for the championship. For that matter, you never thought you'd see The Undertaker squaring off against Kamala.
Nor the Beverly Brothers going against the Natural Disasters for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship.
And speaking of championships, of course, you never thought you'd see the Hitman Bret Hart defending the title against his brother-in-law, the British Bulldog. I mean, there is indeed so much here in SummerSlam. It is the SummerSlam you thought you'd never see. We had an occasion to speak to Martel about his upcoming match.
Yes, Tatanka, your eagle feathers are now mine for good. And on IQ, they will bring me luck, like a SummerSlam. When I meet you, Shawn Michaels, and I give you all the reasons why you should be so jealous of me.
Well, I don't know who's going to be jealous of whom, but you have to wonder just who will walk from the ring with Sherry at their side. I think Sherry could very easily fall for the model Rick Martel if, in fact, he's victorious. And I think, actually, that's probably what's going to happen.
Oh, I don't think so. Shawn Michaels, that's her toy boy. She's not going to leave Shawn Michaels.
I think Sherry will leave with whomever the winner is at SummerSlam. But what a matchup between these two. I think it's going to be a great one. Look at this. Look at the model really going to work now.
Well, if anybody can hang with the model Rick Martel move for move, it is Shawn Michaels.
Yes. And a reversal there. Whoa, Marky flip from the... nope. Uh-oh. And down.
See how he took his time at the top of that? Tried to get a crowd reaction out of that. That's wrong.
Yep. The model Rick Martel. Oh, my.
He'll deliver it. What a great wrestler this guy is.
He is a great wrestler. And again, he is arrogance personified. Trying to get him over. Austin.
Forget about it.
Yes, indeed. Victorious once again, the model Rick Martel. On his way to SummerSlam. The lockup with Shawn Michaels. And on his way with a collision course, no doubt, with the undefeated Native American, Tatanka.
I'm going to give me a hat like that. That's pretty cool.
Look at this. Let's go back to the replay.
Here you see it just jerking the guy right to the back of his head. And there it is. There's no getting out of that.
The model Rick Martel, part of the SummerSlam you thought you'd never see.
And in a matchup sure to be talked about in Vanity Fair, the model Rick Martel goes head-to-head with this man who is standing by with sensational Sherry. Let's hear from Shawn Michaels.
You know, Rick Martel, you have no fashion sense whatsoever. You do not wear a feather with a tuxedo and...
There is going to be more from London in late August as Shawn Michaels takes on the model Rick Martel in the battle of, well, the pretty boys. Let's get comments, because they are in the building, from Shawn Michaels and sensational Sherry.
You know, at SummerSlam in Wembley Stadium, there are 80...
place in just 2 weeks, Saturday night, August 22nd. Also, Tatanka, he faces the model Rick Martel. The feathers at stake in that encounter. The Legion of Doom will join forces with Paul Ellering in a six-man tag team match.
My, oh my, what a matchup that is going to be. Now in the showdown that gives new meaning to the song, You're So Vain, Carly Simon, Please. The model, Rick Martel, takes on Shawn Michaels, accompanied by his heartthrob, sensational Sherry. By the way, folks, I've been informed that Sherry is standing by. Oh, sensational Sherry. Sweetheart, are you there? Sherry, I understand you've got some stipulations you'd like to see in this match between Rick and Sean. What about it?
Yes, I have come up with what I think is the most perfect stipulation.
Monday, the 28th of September at the Sheffield Arena. Also, Tuesday, the 29th of September, you can see it all at the NEC Arena in Birmingham.
Yes, I can't wait for this tour. Especially, I can't wait to give you people the opportunity, the thrill, to see the model live in color. Of course, the model is in a class by himself. But now, you'll see what I mean. You'll see the model outclass everybody. With arrogance, of course. I'm going to destroy whoever I'm going to wrestle. I guarantee you, a model is worth 1,000 words.
It just doesn't get any better.
Hey, good looks will be on the line in the Battle of the Pretty Boys. Shawn Michaels beats the model Rick Martel. Sensational Sherry has had both of these men promise there will be no hitting in the face. Plus, more titles on the line. World Wrestling Federation.
Mr. Perfect, still as of yet to let us in on in whose corner you are going to be tomorrow night. Hello.
I'm here. Don't worry about it. I want to watch the model.
Well, that's all well and good, but we'd like to have an indication of where you're going to be. This is our last matchup for the hour on WWF Superstars. It's about time you give it up.
All right, I'll tell you right after this match.
The model, you think the lights are a little too bright for the model? Although maybe he's accustomed to bright lights, being the he's a European model that he is. Uh-oh, some fans about ringside apparently do not like the smell of arrogance. The cologne endorsed personally by the model, Rick Martel.
Selling arrogance. Big all over the world, too.
What is that? What is that stuff you have on? That's not arrogance, is it?
That's natural, McMahon. I always smell this way. I'm perfect.
Oh, I see. The model, Rick Martel, preparing for his matchup against Justin Taylor. What kind of matchup are we going to see tomorrow night live when the model Rick Martel locks up with Shawn Michaels? How about that maneuver, huh?
It's a great wrestling move. I think the matchup we're going to see tomorrow night, well, no hitting in the face. Neither one wants to.
You know, I can't believe that. As a matter of fact, I don't believe that. I mean, what is this, the fourth grade or something?
No hitting in the face.
Oh, that's real cute, McMahon. Hey, these two guys got beautiful faces. They don't want to put a blemish on it.
Yeah, well, you can bet both of them are lying through their prospective pearly white teeth. Because I would suggest to you and to everyone else that the first opportunity the model has, or for that matter, Shawn Michaels, I believe they're going to blast each other right in the kisser.
Well, it's a possibility. This is the SummerSlam you thought you'd never see.
Take a look at the model. Well, right now, take a look at Sensational Sherry. We spoke to her a little bit earlier.
I'm so excited. This Monday night at SummerSlam, Shawn Michaels is going to take on Rick the Model Martel. And both men have promised me at no point in time will there be any hitting in the face whatsoever. Therefore, there's no reason why either man should have to lose any of those distinguishing looks.
A reminder, there will be no live broadcast of SummerSlam itself tomorrow night. There will, however, be a broadcast of the SummerSlam special tomorrow night at 8 o'clock on Sky Sports. That will be followed by this Monday night's delayed broadcast of SummerSlam itself this Monday afternoon, I should say, at 4 o'clock, also on Sky Sports. And right now, the model Rick Martel, after having a few anxious moments earlier with Justin Taylor, appears to, in control, and it's just about over. Boston Crab applied. Come on, let him up. Let him up. The pearly whites of the model, Rick Martel. Take a look at those beautiful features, because they could be fractured features after tomorrow night.
No, there's no hitting in the face.
Yes, there is. Do you wait and see? I think Shawn Michaels will blast the model, and unquestionably, well, Rick Martel will do the same to Shawn Michaels, and Sherry will be at ringside to witness the horror.
He has no class, just
like all of you.
What a trendsetter.
Quite extraordinary indeed as he heads to SummerSlam tomorrow night.
It'll be interesting to see if the model Rick Martel and Shawn Michaels can adhere to the...
WWF action.
Well, I guess that settles that.
I beg your pardon?
Who the number one contender is?
I didn't get much out of Jimmy Hart in terms of whom he was going to designate as number one contenders, did you?
Yeah, of course. Let's watch the model here. Why don't you start listening a little bit more?
His opponent.
Well, I must say, I don't think Jimmy Hart gave away, except... Look at this.
Going nuts over the model.
Martel.
What a trendsetter.
Andre Agassi, eat your heart out, huh?
Oh, yeah.
However, he sort of reminds me a little bit more of Gabriella Sabatini with those pink pumps on.
I heard she offered to give tennis lessons to the model. Not that he needed them, but just on the side.
I see. I wonder how the model's backhand is.
Probably about as good as his forehand is.
Well, how good would that be? Something less than perfect. Let's just leave it at that, right?
Really good, but nobody's perfect except Mr. Perfect.
And you have played the game of tennis before.
Oh, right? Yeah.
I see.
I can do it all.
Rick Martel. Disrobing, preparing for his matchup. Martel, a proponent of Icapro, no doubt.
No doubt. Look at the body on this guy.
Oh, come on, let's wrestle, please. Look at the little... the pink.
Settle down, everybody. Settle down.
I want a 3.2.
Oh, yeah. Look at the guy giving the sign, too. He's a real winner, right?
Well,
like he's a perfect 10.
The model Rick Martel, whether he's on the runways of Paris, France, or in the squared circle in the WWF, he is always ranked among the top contenders.
And with good reason. Good wrestling experience, knows how to take the holds on and off.
Well, nice reversal there by Ross Greenberg.
You're not going to out-wrestle the model. Look at that.
Nice maneuver.
Good to stay limber during your match.
I see. I mean, showing off doesn't have anything at all to do with it, right?
If you got something to show off, you might as well show it off.
Oh, I see.
Unlike you, better keep that body covered.
Hey. A slam by the model. And Ross Greenberg goes down to the canvas again.
Yes, with the fall season coming up. You know, the model is a very busy man. All the famous designers from all over the world are calling me. They all want me to model their clothes because they know I am the best. Yes, the model is still in vogue.
Boy, he looks great, doesn't he?
Still in vogue and still in GQ. I wonder if he'll ever make it to the cover of the WWF magazine. Then he's made it.
I'm sure he'll be there.
Greenberg over the top, dumped to the outside. That's sort of a humiliating tactic, and as far as I'm concerned, a real shortcut by a veteran like Martel.
Oh, it's just like throwing the garbage over the fence into the neighbor's yard.
Yeah. You do that? Look at that.
I don't touch my garbage. I have people to do that for me.
You don't touch your garbage?
No.
I see. Why not?
Because it's garbage.
The model Rick Martel hammering away on Ross Greenberg. And Greenberg with a nice reversal now. Off the rope.
Whoa.
Missing with a dropkick.
Like I said before, you're not going to out-wrestle the model.
Oh, I don't know about that. Some would come very, very close.
Yeah, close.
Taking nothing away from the athleticism of the model Rick Martel. Quite frankly, I've seen more in terms of scientific knowledge displayed in the past by the model that we are seeing this week. However, as a result, it involves in grab, submission hold, too much pressure on the spine, it's all over, and the model is once again victorious.
The model, Rick Martel!
So the model just Superstars, like he said, still in vogue. Back to the replay.
There you see the model. Nobody's going to out-wrestle the model, Rick Martel. Look at that leg sweep. Beautifully done. Couple jumping jacks. What a trendsetter.
Speaking of trendsetters, let's take you to Sean Mooney.
Well, October has arrived, but it might...
Here's another great match just added to the Survivor Series. Rick the Model Martel will be meeting Native American Tatanka. And as you heard last week, the coffin match between The Undertaker and the Uganda...